Hi guys, I am Paint Director and today I am going to show you how you can make animation using MS Paint and how I make every animation on my channel using MS Paint. In this video, I am going to talk about how to make animation, its advantages and disadvantages, and some tips and tricks to make your animation look smoother. So without any delay, let's get started. First, think of a topic. The topic can be anything like a situation, stereotype, trending meme, or whatever you want. Just beware that the topic should be relatable to the audience you are presenting to, or else no one will take interest in your animation. Second, write the script. Script writing should be done very carefully as it is the foundation of your animation. Take your time to think and write the script. The more time you take, the better the script will be. Unless you just make a blank page for your script and leave it for years as it is. Third, make a folder where your frames will go. After you made the script, make a folder related to your animation name topic where you will put all your frames, audio, and probably videos. This one organized folder will help you in many ways. Fourth, start animating. Open MS Paint and start animating your story. To animate the story, you first need a good character design in your mind. When you have a finalized character, start making the animation. Here are some tips for animating in MS Paint. 1. Set your canvas size. Canvas size should be the same throughout the whole animation. Dimensions for portrait animation should be 4:3 and for landscape, it should be 16:9. If you have any other plans, the dimension may vary but should remain constant during the whole animation. 2. Use different and vibrant colors for your story. MS Paint has a huge collection of 16 million colors. 3. Don't make new frames for the second frame. Use the existing frame for the second frame by which you could get the idea of where to place objects for better animation. 4. For a simple animation, use a different color for the second frame in the existing frame. When your second frame is completed, erase the existing frame colors and repaint the second frame color to match the animation. 5. Use the zoom in and zoom out feature for detailing in the frame. 6. Press and hold the shift key while drawing any shape. It helps in keeping the shape dimension constant. 7. To save frames, use the save as feature and name the frames as 1, 2, 3 because of which the frames will be saved in chronological order and it will be easy to compile them later. Save all the frames in the folder you created before. 8. Make a thumbnail for your animation. It is better to make a thumbnail if you want to present your animation to someone. Make thumbnail as good as you can because it gives a context of what is present in your animation and a good thumbnail will attract more viewers. 5th, video editing. Now MS Paint is not an animation software, but we are still using it to animate and so to make a good animation, we need a good video editor. Take any video editor of your choice. I will use VSDC video editor and import your frames in it. Set the timings of your frames. For 24 FPS animation, you need to set each frame time as 0.04 to milliseconds, and for 30 FPS animation, you need to set 0.033 millisecond time for each frame. When your frames are in position, put audio in it, and if you planned, you can also add video in your animation. And once the editing is done, your animation is complete.
Oh my God! Wow!
Now the only thing left is to export your video and save it to your device and if you planned, you can also share it on YouTube. As you have noticed, Making animation in MS Paint is very difficult, and that is not only a disadvantage it has. 1. You can't use the onion skin technique in MS Paint, which is the whole reason you can't animate in MS Paint. 2. This software was made for minor tweaking in photos and not to animate. 3. The images are in raster form, which means if you zoom in on an image, you will see pixels in it, which does not look good in animation. The disadvantages list can go on, but there are some advantages of doing this hard work, which is more of a reason I use MS Paint as my animation software. 1. You can make a unique YouTube channel. 2. You can sometimes stun viewers with the level of animation which is made in MS Paint. 3. You can use MS Paint as animation software if you are not good at hand drawing but still want to animate, my reason to choose MS Paint. 4. It's free of cost. Now, these advantages are more than enough for me to animate in MS Paint, and I hope you also learned something from this video tutorial. Who knows, maybe I can get a competitor in the future. That's all for this tutorial. See you all next time. Roll the outro. We'll be right back.